السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم عليه. الله سبحانه وتعالى states in his glorious Quran. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا. It is the right of Allah over the mankind that they, when they are able to come and perform Hajj and Umrah, to come and perform the Hajj around the Kaaba, do the Tawaf and all other rituals of Hajj. It is compulsory to perform, to go on Hajj once in a believer's lifetime. And it is recommended, or it is sunnah, to repeat the Hajj and Umrah whenever it is possible, for whoever it is possible. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of us to go and perform Hajj again and again, if that is what pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, this evening, we must pray especially for all those Hujjaj, all our brothers and sisters who will be going for Hajj, to name them Haji Mahmoud Ali and his wife Mrs. Azmat, as well as our brother Shamil and his wife also is going, no? Okay. And Imam Sharif, his wife, and others who have already gone or going, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them with Hajj Maqbool and Mabroor.
Ameen.
My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, of course, Hajj reforms a person. It purifies a believer. It brings that believer back home with no sins at all. All sins forgiven, completely washed off. And most of the believers, 99% of the believers who go on Hajj, they do not waste their time. They do not come back without crying and praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking for his forgiveness. And that is what the tawbah is. Tawbah is also involved in Hajj. So again, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the family of Haji Mahbub Ali and others to complete their Hajj Maqbool and Mabroor and come back to meet us again, as the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained. Whoever has performed Hajj, came back without committing any major mistakes over the Hajj, he or she would be coming back just like a firstborn or just-born babies. In other words, they got no sins at all, all washed off, subhanAllah. That's amazing. Why not? Because looking at the Kaaba, the first house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, itself is a great act of ibadah. You don't need to do anything, just to stare at. Look at that beautiful Kaaba. It will bring in your hearts and minds the highness or the honor and respect for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you see that Kaaba even from far. That will bring so much of great feeling in your hearts and minds that, yes, I have been facing towards this Qibla, this Kaaba, for all my life, from far away. But now I am here, just here, that my eyes openly can see this beautiful Kaaba that has been built by Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and his son Ismail alayhi salam. And not just that, so many hundreds of thousands of Anbiya kiram, Awliya kiram, Salihin, Hujjat came from different parts of the world and performed their Hajj around this Kaaba. And I'm getting that opportunity to walk around in this Kaaba on the same places where they have placed their holy feet. Subhanallah, it's a great blessing. Forgive me, my dear brothers and sisters, and forgive me, Haji Mahbubani and Master Shaban, and the dear MC, Shaykh, that I will be now, inshallah, shifting towards another topic with your permission, inshallah. Because if we have to talk about the Hajj, inshallah, we can go on and on. But I have something very important, because you all have are familiar with what happened recently, that a number of our masajid mosques and the brothers worshippers were praying in their masjids. They were abused and insulted. And on top of that, in the meantime, I don't want to forget to thank those community leaders, Muslim leaders. It's part of our duty to thank them and appreciate the way, alhamdulillah, they responded. It was in a beautiful way, most beautiful way. No one actually swear at them, back at them, or no one used any wrong words or wrong language, or no mosque was provoked. Alhamdulillah, those who faced, they handled the situation the best way they could. Alhamdulillah. And we also thank the government for taking some measures against those who abused our masajid. Now, what that is not, alhamdulillah, that is not what I'm going to. We know that we have to be tolerant, we have to be calm, and we have to address those problems, especially when we are living in a country, in a multicultural country like this. We need to use, we behave or reciprocate wisely. That is true. But where I want to touch is today, that while those guys came to abuse, they were trying to insult and belittle our Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah. And many brothers and some of the sisters, now and then they contacted me, they asked me directly, and they requested me to explain and to increase our trust and love for the Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After hearing, because the media, when they were covering, they picked some particular words of those guys, the words that actually belittling our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or insulting our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that was so hurting for a believer. But remember, my dear brothers, we should never get provoked. That's very important, that we should not get provoked when they are doing that kind of things, because it's not the first time. In the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it repeated so many times. And he sallallahu alaihi wasallam managed so many situations like that, dark situations like that, in a beautiful way, peaceful way. So, however, it is important for us to understand what those guys were saying in relation to the marriage of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with Sayyidatina Aisha radiallahu anha, our mother, the mother of the believers, Ummul Mu'mini. First of all, my dear brothers and sisters, it is important for us to know who was Sayyidatina Aisha radiallahu anha. I would challenge the world to show me, to bring to me a name, a single person, man or woman, who was so brilliant like Sayyidatina Aisha radiallahu anha. Bring me any wife in the world who can be as good as smart as Aisha radiallahu anha. We all have wives. I have a wife. You all brothers have wives, most of you. Now tell me, you go and ask mom and say, look, you know, I've been living with you for a few years. How many things do you know about me? I told you so many things today and yesterday and then yesterday. Can you repeat that? Can you tell me what I told you? Can you share with someone else about my life. I can tell you, my dear brothers, with all due respect, our wives are lovely wives. They love us. They respect us. But expect that majority of them will fail to narrate what you said or what you did without any mistakes, accurately. Same thing about us. However, Sayyidatina Aisha radiallahu anha was so successful to bring to us so much about, so many details about our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Over 3,000 hadith that includes the sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, actions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and approvals of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sayyidatuna Aisha radiallahu anha shared with the world micro details of the private life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No other lady, no other person can complete or provide this service. This was a unique service. You need a young person of her age who would be sharing to the world the private life of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, and other hundreds of thousands of Sahaba, they were there to tell us, to share with the world how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's public life was. But we are here looking at the Prophet who can provide us the micro details about the entire walks of our life. That's our Prophet. Our religion, alhamdulillah, proudly we can say that this religion has covered every detail. Now that is only possible if a brilliant, most intellectual lady, girl was positioned in his house, placed in his house, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's house. And do remember and recall everything that the Prophet was saying and doing. And Aisha radiallahu anha completed that duty. She was the second person who has reported the most hadith, transmitted the most hadith to the world.